In outcome harvesting, an outcome is a behavioral change in a social actor that your intervention has contributed to. It is important to take note of smaller but still significant changes in behavior, as well as those that were unintended. This is because small changes are often steps that lead to larger ones, and so they are the key to understanding the process of change. Outcomes may take time to emerge, and not every activity leads to an outcome. Outcome statements always have at least three parts: the outcome description, its significance, and your contribution. Now let's look at each part of an outcome statement. The outcome description is a short and factual narrative of a behavioral change, meaning what people are doing differently. The outcome description answers the questions: who changed? What did they do differently? Where? And when? You will find that it takes some time and discussion to write a good quality outcome description. Let's go back to look at the first draft of this outcome description. In November 2016, young men from Brong-Ahafo region in Ghana participated in a training at the AADK Global Platform in Ghana. Here is some good advice on how to write a good outcome description. First, focus on what observably has changed and not what you did. This means you should use active and concrete phrases such as attended, signed, stopped, or organized. And avoid using vague language such as increased awareness or strengthened capacity. Also remember to write out all abbreviations to make it understandable for outsiders. Last, avoid value statements which are subjective and cannot be verified, such as very important or very successful meeting. Now you have a concise, factual, and observable outcome description that any audience can understand. In November 2016, five young men from Brong-Ahafo region in Ghana organized weekly demonstrations to advocate on gender-based violence and women's rights in their community. After the outcome description comes the outcome's significance, or why this outcome is important. You explain the importance, such as if the change is the first of its type, it represents a systemic change, or it contributes to sustainability. The significance should convey to an external reader why the outcome is important. Brong-Ahafo is a region with a high number of cases of gender-based violence, particularly sexual violence. This outcome is significant because it was the first time young men from that community took action for women's rights and gender-based violence. This action introduced gender-based violence and women's rights as topics to be discussed in the community. Next, you describe the activities you have implemented that have plausibly contributed to the outcome. You are looking for a change in the social actor because of something that you did, whether your contribution was big or small. The demonstrations were initiated by participants from a training at the ActionAid Denmark Global Platform in Ghana in October 2016. The training focused on gender-based violence and linked to a broader campaign in Ghana. During the training, young people developed knowledge of women's rights, feminist leadership, and campaigning. Outcomes come in different shapes and sizes, depending on the actors at play and the context at hand. It can take time to refine the outcome statements, but it is important that this process takes place to ensure accuracy and use value of the description. The writing of outcome statements takes some practice, so feedback from an experienced harvester is important to generate the best results.